Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam.
Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papavinashaktam. Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyanaloka pradipakam, vande shantam.
सदाशिवसमारंभां ज्ञानसम्बन्धाचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां
प्राणायाम सेसेशन ऑफ ब्रीदिंग. Please understand, I am not translating pranayama as control of breathing. All the orthodox translations say control of breathing. I am translating. Cessation means completely stopping. When I say the word cessation of breathing, I mean breathing which you experience every day, every moment, which awakens the thought also along with the air movement, should be stopped. Cessation of air movement with thoughts is what I call breathing. That should be stopped. See, what you understand as breathing is air movement with thoughts also being awakened. That should be stopped. That is what I call pranayama. So, I don't want to use the word control of breathing. Prana and breathing is not equivalent words. Please understand, it is not translation. Breathing means air movement with thoughts. Prana means air movement without thoughts. Along with the air movement, if the thoughts are also awakened, you are not inhaling pure prana, the life energy. Please understand these few things. Air is not life energy. There is a subtle energy goes inside along with air. That is what is called prana. Air is like a lorry. And prana is the object goes inside the lorry. Like how lorry comes here and unloads what we bought, the objects, and goes back. Same way, the life energy is carried by the air. It goes inside and the life energy gets unloaded into the body, stays inside, and lorry comes out, means the air comes out. If there is more thought, less life energy will go inside. If there is less thought, more life energy will go inside. If lorry itself is too heavy and only less products can come inside, then what is the use? Lorry should be less weight and more product should come through the lorry.
Blowing your kundalini, that's the literal meaning of pranayama. There are only two ways, either you blow it or I blow it. Technology of awakening your bioenergy, purifying your biomemory, is pranayama. Prana is a kind of a vibration which goes inside along with your breathing, the air. And that vibration stays inside you and continues to add more vibration frequency to the life energy. And that air comes out. That is the exact science. And a few more things you may need to know about this whole movement. Even while you feel that breathing has stopped, still during the deep restful awareness or meditation, the prana continues to go in and comes out. Prana, life breath, is independent of breathing. When you forget yourself in the meditation, prana going in and coming out actually increases. Air going in and coming out may reduce, but the prana going in and settling increases. That is the reason meditation rejuvenates you.
Pranayama, stop your mind to fulfill the breath. Please understand. When you stop the mind, your breathing gets fulfilled. If your mind is interfering with your breathing, it is always unfulfilled. If you feel you have everything in the outer world, but still there is an unfulfillment, your breathing is not fulfilled. The first thing you need to fulfill in your life is your breathing. If you fulfill your breathing, everything will be fulfilled in your life, even though you have so many complications in the outer world. If you have not fulfilled your breathing, you will have a deep emptiness, even if everything is fulfilled in the outer world. Please understand. Even if everything is fulfilled in the outer world, you will not feel fulfilled. You will not feel fulfilled. See, as on now, how you breathe should be understood by you. Your body is like a desert filled with sand. Any air movement happens in your body. See, in the desert, if any air flow, breeze, or the wind happens, what will happen? All the dust will be lifted by the air. And the whole wind become dusty, full of sand. Same way, ordinary body is filled with so much of biomemory, it's like a desert. If too much of biomemory is there, nobody can live. Any air movement, immediately what happens? In that wind, all this dust is lifted. So the breathing, by its nature, awakens too many thoughts and engrams and makes you restless. See, if you don't want the air to be contaminated by the sand, either become a rock or become an ocean. Becoming rock means by your own sadhana, unclutching and integrating yourself. So no thought during breathing. That's one method. Second, if you think, no, when can sand become stone? By my practice? Or at least be one with the ocean. Just go and become one with the ocean. That's what surrendering to God. So naturally, if you become ocean, the air will not have sand. It will not lift sand. It will not get contaminated. There is a third thing. Neither you need to become rock, nor you need to go and surrender to the ocean. Suddenly, a river will start flowing over you. That is what I call grace, compassion of the Master.
Nitya Kriya, restoring Hatha Yoga to the world. A series of healing yogic processes revealed by Paramahamsa Nityananda to care and cure for diseases and disorders. Practice Nitya Kriya and awaken your Kundalini energy. To find out more, visit www.nityananda.org/nitya-kriyas.
The science of absorbing the prana, the life energy, directly, without any means or vehicles, unnecessary load on your system. If you can absorb the highest frequency inside your body without any thought, without thoughts being awakened, that is what
Patanjali calls us pranayamaha. Please understand, the whole purpose of pranayama is breathe without thinking. Whenever there is a thinking, breathing is not complete. Breathing does not take energy inside. It takes only air, which is not really necessary to be inside your body. It is the energy which is basic requirement. The prana is the basic requirement. Because prana is mixed in the air, we take the air also. If there are more thoughts, you will take more air, less prana. If there are less thoughts, you will take less air, more prana. Please understand. It's like a vicious circle. If you take more prana, naturally less thoughts will be there. If you have less thoughts, you will take more prana. Or the other way, if you take less prana, there will be more thoughts. If you have more thoughts, you will take less prana. This vicious circle continuously changing the consciousness of your being. Please understand. If you achieve any stability or state of consciousness through yoga, it is stable, but it takes a lot of time. If you achieve any stability or any higher experience through pranayama, it is instant. Same way, stabilizing it takes a lot of time. The right combination is Yoga Vedanta. Yoga, pranayama, and Vedantic mental setup. Having a strong foundation of ethics and understanding about life. Please understand. When a Kundalini energy is awakened in you by the master's presence or pranayama or some technique, if your mental setup is based on the eternal truths, for example, what you think as life, if you think life is only the time you are going to live in this body, immediately the energy awakened in you will be drained. If you have the understanding, life is eternal, my identity with this body and mind will be constantly changing. Just this simple understanding about life, the energy awakened will stay in you permanently.
Please understand, while you are unclutching, the complete balancing of prana happens in you. You may need more exhaling for your prana balancing. Sometime you need more prana inside. If there is more exhaling, then more prana will be naturally inhaled, pumped inside. Unfortunately, because your exhaling is shallow, your inhaling also becomes shallow. When your inhaling is shallow, the quantity and the quality of prana comes in, reduces. That reduces the awareness and the vital actions of the brain comes down. Please understand. If the quantity and quality of prana intake reduces, the awareness of your brain and the vital functions of your brain comes down. That is why I insist so much on this long breath. Long breath is ajapa-japa. Long breath is unclutching. Long breath is yoga. Long breath is pranayama. Long breath is enlightenment. Long breath is God Himself. The long breath. When I say long breath, breathing up to your knee, not while you are sitting, while you are standing. Breathing up to your knees, that long breath does so much to your physiology and psychology. That is why when your kundalini is awakened, you go through such a silence, restful awareness inside, but outside such long breath will be happening. When you are unclutching, if the breath goes out on its own and leading to a stage of gasping for breath, don't worry, it is perfect. Your prana and samana is getting balanced. Samana or prana getting balanced never happens without pranayama other than unclutching.
Books by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the true spirit of Vedic tradition. More than 250 books of Paramahamsa Nityananda are now available online for free. Access free library at lifeblissprograms.org/books.
First, let us understand something about breath. From the moment of your birth to death, the one and only thing which you do without any discontinuity is breathing. Anything else can be stopped. You may be a child, or you may be young man, or you may become old, or you may fall sick, you may eat, you may not eat, you may sleep, you may not sleep, but you cannot stop breathing. That's a basic thing of life. Breathing is the one and only activity which you are doing continuously. Your being is made out of five elements. Earth, Prithvi, earth element, your bone and the base structure is made out of earth element. Next, water, you know, your blood and so many other things in your system. Water element represents the water element energy. Next, fire, which is constantly burning in your Manipuraka. Next is air, breath, prana, breath element, the air element. The fifth is ether. Ether is your mind, where your visualizations are happening, where your thinking is happening. That space is ether. Five space, five elements are there. And Tantra says, if you can directly work with the subtlest element, you will achieve enlightenment immediately. Working with earth means, then you have to move to the water, then you have to move to the fire, then you have to move to the air, from there you have to move to the ether. You have to move from one step to next. You can see one will be subtler than the other. If you go deep, it will be subtler, subtler and subtlest. The earth and the water will have form, and the fire is formless form. Air and the ether will not have form. Fire can lead from form to formlessness.
These are the five elements. If you can work with the subtlest, straight away you can become enlightened. You can reach the cosmic energy. You can reach the Atman. From Atman comes the Akasha. From Akasha comes the Vayu. From Vayu, Vayu Rapa. From Vayu comes the Agni. From Agni comes the water. From water element comes the Prithvi, earth. If you can work with the subtlest element, straight away you can reach the enlightenment, the inner space. Here the subtlest element is Akasha, ether. But the big difficulty is you cannot directly work with ether. You cannot directly work with ether. You cannot directly work with your mind. The more you try to work with your mind, you may create suppressions and more difficulties. That's the reason Shiva is straight away working with air, little less subtle, but which is practical. You may have a question, how can I become enlightened? Just by watching my breath. How can I become enlightened? Just by going into the space where my breath is taking turn. How enlightenment is possible? Logically, you may not understand, but when you go deep, it happens. It happens. Human beings as such cannot work directly on the ether, on mind. The thing which they can directly touch is only the breath. And breath is the bridge between you and the universe. It is the bridge between your body and the mind. You can see very clearly. Till breath, you are only body. After the breath, you are mind. If you see all the five elements. Till the air, you are only body. Whether it is earth, water, or fire, or the air. All these four are only body. But after the breath, after the air, after the prana, it is mind. The ether is mind. The breath is the bridge between your body and mind. Your matter and spirit. Body is the matter. Spirit is the energy. Breath is the bridge between your body. Please be very clear. Constantly you are connecting with the universe. You are relating with cosmos through the breath. Once the breathing goes in and before it turns out, it touches your inner space. Let it be very clear. Every single breath is directly managed by your Atman, not by your mind. Let it be very clear. That is why even if you forget, you go on breathing. It is not under the control of your mind. It is under the control of consciousness. Every single breath, you go and touch your inner consciousness. You straight away go and reach your inner consciousness, then come out. Every single breath is directly related to your inner consciousness. That is the easiest method to reach enlightenment. Let me be very clear. With any other technique, you have to do something. Here, you don't have to do anything. Just be. And automatically you will be taken into the space where the enlightenment is happening. Automatically you will reach the space where consciousness is your nature. Automatically you will enter into the space where you are in Shiva consciousness. Every moment you are reaching the space of Shiva consciousness, you are entering into the space of Shiva consciousness without even your knowledge. Only thing, all you need to do is just be with the vehicle which goes into the inner space of Shiva consciousness. If you just keep quiet and sit in the train, that is enough. Your breath is the train, vehicle, which is going into the Shiva consciousness every moment. But the moment it goes near the Shiva consciousness, you feel a little suffocated and you say, no, this is not for me, let me get down, you get down. And when the train comes back to your station, you get into the train and come back again. Just before the turning up, there will be always a gap where you don't breathe, where the breath is not happening, where it is taking turn. If you can relax in that gap, if you can be aware of that gap, a sudden explosion of consciousness is possible in you. You may think, how can I achieve enlightenment? Just by watching the gap between the breaths. Please be very clear. Your breathing and your thinking are directly connected. They are directly connected. If you observe the length, breadth and depth of your breath, it changes according to your thoughts. Let me be very clear. Every single thought changes the length, breadth and depth of your breathing. Length, breadth and depth of your breathing can never be the same with two different thoughts. Every single thought brings a change, a slight change, maybe in length or in breadth or in depth of your breathing. Every single thought is associated with a particular length, breadth, depth of your breathing. So your breathing is not same as you think. You can see this obviously when you are caught in some emotions. Emotions like anger, you can see your breathing totally changes. Emotions like lust, you can see that your breathing is totally different. The emotions, when you are caught in the emotions, you can see how your breathing changes. You think only in the high emotions, your breathing changes. Not only in the high emotions, even in ordinary thinking, even in an ordinary way of thinking, every thought has got its own length, breadth, depth of breath. Be very clear, every single thought brings its own change in your breathing. If you work on your breath, straight away you work on your mind. If you work on your mind, you are straight away working on your breath. But the difficulty is you can't work on your mind. You cannot work on your mind. It is too subtle. It is too subtle. You cannot do anything. Try your best to work on your mind. End of the day you will feel only bored or tired. One more thing, if you observe, if you stop breathing, you can't think. Your thinking will stop. Even for a moment, stop breathing, thinking will stop. And if you stop thinking, breathing will stop. You can't stop thinking completely, but you can enter into the space where breathing is not happening in you. You can beautifully enter into that space without any side effect or after effect. The only byproduct or side effect will be enlightenment.
Trust in you, 'cause you know it's best for me to lead a blissful life, a life with no more strife. I can't believe the things I do, just to spend a little time with you. Nothing will compare, I know you will take care.
You're always showing us compassion, your love is endless like an ocean. Nithyananda, Nithyananda, my life's become a meditation. If this is, we had a deep connection. Nithyananda.
whenever the incoming breath takes a turn as outgoing breath, it is. And whenever the outgoing breath takes turn, becomes an incoming breath, again you experience the neutral space. Your breath moves in only a circular way. It is not parallel line as you think, because it goes in a straight way. You think it's a parallel line. It's not parallel. It takes a turn. Parallel lines never meet. Your breathing and mind both are very closely associated. The prana and mana, prana sarira and mana sarira are very closely connected to each other. If the prana becomes slow, the number of thoughts per second also reduces. Along with the length, breadth, depth of the prana, thoughts per second also reduces. Please understand. The length, breadth, depth of the prana or the breathing is directly related to the number of thoughts which you are having. If the, for example, here, if the prana is slowly coming down, slowly going into the inner space to take turn. This is the space in which it takes turn. It's an ingoing, incoming, outgoing. This is the prana. Along with that, mind also slowly slows down. Very slowly slows down. But the difficulty, you are afraid of losing your mind. You are afraid of losing your mind. That is why you never keep your awareness in this zone. This is like a neutral zone. If you know driving, you can understand. Whenever you shift gear from first gear to second gear or second gear to third gear or any change, you have to come to neutral zone. Only after coming to the neutral zone, you can change the gear. Even if it is from first to second, or second to third, or third to first, whatever it is, you have to come to the neutral zone. Same way, the incoming breath taking turn as outgoing breath, this turn, this zone is a neutral zone. This is neutral zone. You are afraid of this neutral zone because in this neutral zone you are empty. You don't have any identity. The biggest fear human beings have is fear of losing identity. Fear of losing the identity. I tell you, even fear of losing death is not great fear, like fear of losing identity. Fear of losing death itself is nothing but you don't know how you will be after death. If you are very clear, you will be in some way, you don't have the fear. Here, you are not very clear about how you will be after death, how you will be after you leave the body. It is the identity, the fear of losing identity that is much worse than fear of death. Here, when you pass through this neutral zone, when your breath stops, your mind also stops. You do not want this space. That is why you just jump this space. You never keep your awareness. You are never aware of this space because you do not want to lose your identity. If your mind stops, you will not have identity for a few moments. You will lose your identity and you always think you are only identity. You exist just only on identity. When you feel your identity is lost, you feel you are no more. That's the reason whenever you come to this zone, you just take a jump. You are never aware of this zone. Every moment this zone is happening in you again and again. Whenever your incoming breath takes outgoing as outgoing, or outgoing takes as incoming, This is also neutral zone. But you are afraid of these two neutral zones. You just take a jump. You do not want to be aware of this space. Every moment, when the incoming breath takes as outgoing, outgoing takes as incoming, you are afraid of this neutral zone, because in neutral zone you don't exist. In neutral zone, your identity is lost. You do not want to be aware of losing your identity. You do not want to lose your identity. You are so obsessed with your identity. You are so caught. You are completely caught with your identity. You do not want to even remain for a moment, even for a chana. You do not want to be without your identity. Constantly you are protecting your identity. But the big problem is, your identity is completely social. It is not existential. It is just comparative reality. It is not existential reality. Whatever you think as your identity, your money, relationship, your age, your sex, whatever you call as your identity, it is just societal, unsuicidal. Societal, unsuicidal. It is not the existential reality. It is just comparative reality. But the big thing is, you are afraid of existential reality and trying to protect your comparative reality, but you think you are protecting something which is. It's a real fun actually. You are trying to protect which is not against which is. Which is your reality, that neutral space, that gap. Which is not is your comparative reality, your identity. You are trying to protect your identity against your reality. That is where you miss the whole game. That is why our life is a big failure. You are trying to protect which is not. You are trying to fight for which is not against which is. See, the light has got an existence. It has got positive existence. But darkness doesn't have positive existence. It exists only in a negative way. It doesn't have positive existence. You are trying to protect which doesn't have positive existence against which has got positive existence. In this space, in this zone, the neutral zone, the inner space or consciousness is the reality. It is a truth. It exists in you every moment. Every moment when your incoming breath takes turn as outgoing breath, or outgoing breath takes turn as incoming breath, you are in that neutral space. You are in that consciousness. But you neither wanted to experience nor feel comfortable with that zone. You are so caught up in your identity, especially with the Western culture, surrender means death. Just by hearing the word surrender, people get frightened. But you don't know, you are trying to protect something which doesn't have basic existence. You see, all your identity. Your identity is what your mind. This is what is your identity, the mind. This is breath. It's a breath and it's mind. Mind is nothing but your identity. Again here, outgoing breath, mind. This is the zone. Neither breath is happening nor the mind is working. This is the zone where both stop. When your breathing stops, when your mind stops, you experience the zone of consciousness. This is what I call neutral zone. The difficulty is, if your mind doesn't feel comfortable, if your identity doesn't feel comfortable, then naturally you just jump this zone. You do not want this zone in your life. Constantly you are trying to avoid God. Constantly you are trying to escape from God. Constantly you are trying to escape from consciousness. The main thing, you need to feel comfortable with that neutral zone. The more you feel comfortable, more you feel protected, more you feel secured with that neutral zone, you will start experiencing the neutral zone again and again. When you start experiencing the neutral zone, you will stay in consciousness. And if your identity is based on the outer world, you will not feel comfortable in that neutral zone. Person who feels comfortable in the neutral zone will be constantly rejuvenated. That is what I call eternal bliss. Constantly you will be energized. Understand? It's like every moment you are sent to a high plane. Every moment you are high. Every moment, if you start feeling comfortable with the neutral zone, every moment you get high on prana. Prana means the life source, the life force, the energy or the consciousness which is the base for your existence. Let it be very clear, the word prana does not mean air. In Sanskrit, the prana has got deeper meaning. It is not simply air. It's like air is a product delivered from the outer world. Prana is the energy which you receive from the product. If you can be comfortable in that neutral zone, every moment, again and again, you will be rejuvenated, flooded with energy. In this lower neutral zone, when the incoming takes outgoing turn, you are flooded with energy. When the outgoing takes the turn of incoming, you are flooded with intelligence. Please understand, as I was saying yesterday, incoming is life, outgoing is death. Incoming breath is life, outgoing breath is death. This is the lifeline and this is death. With the life, you are flooded with energy. With the death, you are flooded with intelligence. If you are unaware, you will miss the energy and miss the intelligence. Every death teaches you. Every death. One more thing. When I use the word death, I don't mean only the physical death. If you lose some money, suddenly you lose $1 million. Some part of your being is dying. That is why you feel so much of pain. Your identity as a millionaire is dying. Same way, even if you don't have good relationship with your parents, if they die, suddenly you feel emptiness, the pain. When you watch both the gaps, when you are aware of both the gaps, you will be constantly flooded with energy and intelligence. If you go a little deep, you will understand one more important thing. Every moment you have thought and energy, 0 and 1. The whole binary system is based on this only. The whole binary system of 0 and 1, the thought and energy, energy and thought, thought and energy, the energy and thought, both are directly related. Actually, you, for a moment you will be flooded with Ichcha Shakti, the next moment you will be flooded with Kriya Shakti. The moment, one moment you are flooded with energy, next moment you are flooded with intelligence. Constantly these two are playing the game. This is the game of Shiva and Shakti. This is the whole cosmos, matter and energy. Constantly in your inner space, Shiva and Shakti are dancing. The matter and energy are dancing. If you can be aware of the gap, you will experience the eternal consciousness, the Shiva consciousness. Icha and Kriya, both are dancing in your inner space. If you can be aware of the gap, you will achieve the Jnana Shakti. The Icha Shakti and Kriya Shakti, both of them are just dancing. The energy is enjoying itself. Energy is expressing itself in your inner space. If you can be little aware, if you can feel comfortable with the gap, suddenly you will see that Jnana Shakti is awakened in you. Here, let you understand, again and again and again, you are flooded with energy. You are flooded with energy. When you start experiencing this inner space, the neutral zone, the source of inspiration will not be the matter for you. It will be spirit. Please understand. As long as the source of inspiration is your identity, you are driven by your identity, you will try to strengthen your identity, which is not there. Which is not there. See, your identity as a rich man will be alive if you are among the poor people. If you go and be with the rich people, what will happen to your identity? It will be lost. Your identity as a young man will be alive if you are with old people. If you are with old people, what will happen? Your identity will disappear. Be very clear. Your identity is completely relative. It is comparative. It is not reality. If you are comfortable only with inhaling and exhaling, you will be strengthening your identity. You will be, your inspiration source will be your identity, and you will be working to strengthen your identity. Means death to death. If you shift your comfort zone, if you start feeling comfortable with the neutral zone, if you start witnessing, if you start observing these two neutral zones, and if you are relaxed in that neutral zone, you will start creating a new source of inspiration for you, which is not your identity, which is not matter. Please be very clear. As long as matter is the inspiration source for you, as long as your identity is inspiration source for you, you cannot be alive, active, eternally. You cannot be alive or active eternally. You will be entering into the space of death again and again, because matter cannot be alive. Matter, by its very nature, is not alive. If you start feeling comfortable with the neutral zone, the spirit will become inspiration source for you. You will be driven. You will become active, alive again and again by the spirit, by the energy and intelligence. Energy and intelligence will become source for your life. Whenever you are flooded with energy, whenever you are flooded with intelligence, you will be able to receive it. You being flooded with intelligence and energy is what I call God consciousness, experiencing Shiva. Do not think experiencing Shiva means somewhere you will see a big god with that four hand and a snake and with a trident. That is not experiencing Shiva. Experiencing Shiva means you being flooded with energy and intelligence. Whenever you are flooded with energy and intelligence, be very clear, you are experiencing Shiva consciousness. You may be aware or unaware. but you are experiencing Shiva consciousness.
Dial the avatar. Paramahamsa Nityananda answers your questions live during the daily morning satsang every day at 7:30 a.m. Indian Standard Time. We invite you to directly talk to Swamiji and receive his blessings for your life to be filled with bliss and all the auspiciousness. Dial the avatar at 9180 27279999 extension 129.
Please understand, the first level pranayama is just regulating the four actions, four flow. Going in, staying in, coming out, staying out. The second stage of pranayama is elongating. I can say the second stage, I am putting it now serially, elongating that four stages. The third stage of pranayama is stopping in any one of that four stages. The fourth stage of pranayama is, because of being centered in some object internally or externally, if your breathing stops, that is what is fourth. So being centered either on external or on internal object, can lead to the stoppage of air movement, can lead to just prana going in and settling into your system. This is the fourth stage of pranayama. Please understand, concentrating on external object or internal object, and because of that, if your breathing movement stop, you will experience the stage of breathing without thinking. Breathing may not happen, but your thinking will not be there. That stage, I can say, is one of the most powerful pranayama, the fourth stage of pranayama. In this stage, you will be able to create anything you want, because all the materials are created out of prana. You will have access to that base material. It's like if you have clay, you can make anything which can be made in clay. Same way, if you have a prana under your control, you can make anything you want, because everything is made out of prana. All the materials made out of prana can be made by you if you achieve this state of stoppage of breath. By being centered, your awareness being centered on something internally or externally. Inhaling, holding the prana which was held in your body, that prana spreading all over your body, and exhaling and cleansing. Inhaling, holding, spreading, exhaling and cleansing. These are the five life breath movements, Pancha Pranas. Prana, Vyana, Udana, Samana, Apana. five movements. If these five movements are balanced and proper, naturally your body will be in health, your mind will be in a balanced space, your consciousness will be soaring higher and higher and higher. Understand? Hundreds and hundreds of good positive effects on your body, mind, consciousness will happen in your system just by balancing this pancha pranas. Please understand, the word prana and apana, you need to understand in depth. Let me give you the deepest meaning of this word prana and apana. Constantly in you, for a moment you remember you exist, and after a few moments you forget you exist, and your mind starts wandering here and there. Try this process. Try to just sit and remember about you. Just though, I exist, I remember me, I exist, I remember me. Just the self-remembrance. Try the self-remembrance. In few seconds you will forget. Please understand, the moments you remember yourself is prana. The moments you forget you exist is apana. Unless you forget you exist, you can't remember you exist. Unless you remember you exist, you won't forget you exist. The prana and apana live together. But how mercury slowly absorbs the gold, prana can absorb apana. If mercury and gold is kept near, if they are touching each other, mercury will swallow the gold and gold will lose its qualities into the mercury. Same way, if the prana is allowed to function, means if the self-remembrance is increased by your conscious will, if you are supporting the self-remembrance by your conscious decision, it will swallow the apana part, the self-forgetting moments. Please understand, a most subtle Vedantic truth, most subtle spiritual truth, if you try to remember yourself, constantly be in the unclutching or remembrance of the higher self, only if you try you will understand what I am saying. Just remembering, I exist, I exist, I am here, I feel me, yes, I am alive, I remember me, I am. If you just remember you, that self-remembrance, for some people that self-remembrance will be there without disturbance, maybe for 3 seconds, for some it will be 10 seconds. Usually none of you will have more than 12 seconds. That is the maximum for a normal conscious being. By the time one flicker of thought will come. If somebody can establish themselves in the self-remembrance for 21 seconds, he is enlightened, Jivan Mukta. 21 seconds is a too long period to be established in that self-remembrance. Then your mind breaks, you become liberated being.
this self remembrance, when you are trying, the thoughts which come because of your forgetfulness, due to your forgetfulness, the forgetfulness is apana, remembrance is prana, forgetfulness is apana. Now, you are not supposed to hate apana. Constantly you create a guilt in you, oh, I forget, the forgetfulness happens to me, I don't remember, I am not qualified. You are constantly worrying and struggling with apana. Stop it. Work on prana. Whenever you remember, understand it is a luck, bonus, gift. Celebrate prana. Celebrate the moments of self-remembrance. Stop feeling guilty. Stop suffering. Stop suffocating yourself for the moments of forgetfulness. But unfortunately, your mind is tuned to suffer the forgetfulness. Work on prana. Don't suffocate yourself with apana.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-223-311. www.nityananda.org.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.